Hey guys, I'm Dylan, and I was going to do a book review of The 100 by Kass Morgan. I do want to start off by saying I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a great book. But before I get too far into my review, I do want to say I've had a lot of people mention me doing book reviews before, and they've been kind of hounding at me to do one. And I'm going to be honest, up until pretty recently, I'd ignored them. But once I decided I was going to do one just a couple days ago, I decided I'd look around on YouTube, try to see if I could find any. Just to see, what people did, how they did it, all that kind of fun stuff. And I'm gonna be honest, in my searchings, I was a little bit surprised to find out I could not find a single other guy who does these. And so either I'm a trendsetter here, or they're just really well hidden. Either way, I'm feeling a little bit lonely over in my corner, but what you gonna do about it, right? Alrighty, so on to the book. 100. I thought, like I said, it was a great book. It did have its dark parts, nothing too depressing or sad, but had a little bit of dark. Wasn't all sunshine and lollipops. So if you like that, might be a good book for you. Now, the people who really enjoy the nitty-gritty, really dark, it's not that. It did have its pieces of light and, well, it doesn't have a happy ending. They have a sequel. But anyway. Let's see, before I forget, it does have a show on the CW. I don't know how new that is. I don't know if that's just now coming on or if they're coming into a new season, but I did see a commercial for it just the other day. I didn't pay enough attention to know if it's for, like I said, a new season or if it's the series premiere. Either way, I'm really looking forward to seeing it and maybe catching up. I definitely think that would be worth your time too. The book. I am actually going to read you guys the back real quick. No one has set foot on Earth in centuries, until now. Ever since a devastating nuclear war, humanity has lived on spaceships far above Earth's radioactive surface. Now, 100 juvenile delinquents are being sent on a dangerous mission to recolonize the planet. It could be their second chance at life, or it could be a suicide mission. Clark was arrested for treason, though she's haunted by the memory of what she really did. Wells came to Earth for the girl he loves, but will she ever forgive him? Bellamy fought his way onto the transport pod to protect his sister, and Glass managed to escape, only to find that life on the ship is just as dangerous as she feared it would be on Earth. In a savage land, the 100 must fight to survive. They were never meant to be heroes, but they may be mankind's last hope. So, like I said, pretty intense, has its dark parts. But the four main characters are going to be Clark, Wells, Bellamy, and Glass. And you're going to have your, lesser main characters, like Bellamy's sister. You're going to see a decent amount of her throughout this book. And Glass drags a few people along through her little tale. And so you're going to see a few of them. And I really like them as characters. I thought they were all very interesting. In one way or another, I think you can relate to probably at least one of them. But, which is always nice to have something in common with them. This book is one of those books that jumps around from characters. So for one chapter, you could be from Clark's perspective, and the next chapter could be from Bellamy's. And so that can be done poorly, but I thought it was done really well here. And I thought they did a very good job of making sure it was interesting and I don't know, keeping me involved in each of the characters, because I've had it before where I'll get really bored with one character and really wanting to move on to the next character, whereas in this book I really was interested in all of them. Just one of those little tidbits. The book list said it was dark and riveting, a mashup of The Lord of the Flies, Across the Universe, and The Hunger Games. And so you can pretty obviously see really where all of those come in. Lord of the Flies and The Hunger Games, that's where you get your survival. Bunch of teenage kids surviving in the wilderness, that's where you're gonna get that little bit. And Across the Universe, they're living in spaceships. So that's where you're gonna get your little bit of sci-fi there. And I do wanna say, I enjoyed that I thought it was original in its own way. Sci-fi is obviously nothing new, but I personally have never read a sci-fi book about teenagers being sent to Earth after a nuclear war. Maybe that's just me. Maybe you guys have all read books like that. But I haven't. That was a new one for me. So that was kind of interesting. I would definitely recommend getting it. I got it for like $5. I think it was on Walmart's $5 bin at one point. So definitely worth it. It is Let me check real quick. Just over 300 pages long, so it didn't take me too long to read, maybe a day or two. So I don't know. I was probably sick at the time, so something just fun to sit and read. Oh, and for you ladies out there, there was a little bit of romance. It wasn't a main part of the book, but it took its fair share of pages. I mean, Wells came to Earth for the girl he loves, so you should get at least a little bit of your romance filling on this one. And so I think it reaches out to a lot of people who like a lot of genres. As I've said a million times before, I enjoyed it and I would highly recommend it. I think I'm gonna call that good for today. So, the 100. There we go. 100, ladies and gentlemen.